have to look proud and to have, as I was taken as the deed was done.
For Daphne, roaming through the thorny woods, scratching the legs that lunge us where she pleads. Now that sight shall sad, cold, and to work with me the blood and tears are dry.
Thou art a lord and nothing but a lord. Thou hast a lady far more beautiful and able with an estimating age.
And two of tears that she has shed for me, like envious floods or running lonely hills. She was the fairest creature in the world, yet fairer to none.
Am I a lord and have I such a lady? Or do I treat, or have I dreamed till now? I do not sleep, I see, I hear, I speak, I smell sweet savors, I feel soft things. Upon my life, I am a lord indeed, and not a taker, nor a Christopher's son. Well, bring our lady hither to our sight, and once again, a hot or the smallest thing.
Let me flee to readiness to wash your hands. Oh, how many joys to see a cup in store. Now once more in English material. These 15 years you have been a dream. Am I right? So it is me, Scott.
These 15 years, by my faith, a goodly neck. But did I have to speak of all that time?
Oh, yes, my lord, but very angry. For though you lay here in the chain, yet would you say you were beaten at the door and fell upon most of the house? And yet would you enroll and say you present her at the feet, because she grabbed a stone there for no sake of course. Sometimes you call Sicily.
The woman, the maid of the house.
Why, sir, we don't have such house, no such man, no such man as you have right now. As Peter Tripp and Henry Pickering, and 20 years of sweet sense, and as Peter's which neither Lord nor no man ever saw.
Thou Lord be thanked for my good amends.
Amen.
I thank thee, thou shalt not be tried.
How very fitting, Lord.
Very farewell, for you is true enough. Where is my wife?
Here, noble lord, let us settle with her.
Are you my wife, and don't call me husband? I meant to call me lord. I'm Rupert.
My husband and my lord, my lord and husband, I'm your wife and all of you.
I know it well. What must I call you? Madam, Alistair, what you ask? Madam, and nothing else, the lord will tell you. Fat of love, it's fair and slow, and it's been above some 15 years or more.
I say it's 30 unto me.
Your honor declares, hearing your men, are come to play a pleasant comedy.
And so your doctors will look very mean, seeing too much sadness after the guilt of blood, and melancholy makes the worst of friends. Therefore, if I pitch your play, and frighten the mind to mother merriment, which bars a thousand hearts and many times.
Man, so let them play. It is not an unlucky a Christmas gathering or a couple of children.
No, my good lord, it is not a Christmas sad.
What? A school fun?
It is a kind of history.
Well, we'll see it. Come, my good wife, sit by my side. Let the world sit. We shall never be done.
Only good master, while we do admire this virtue. profit grows and there is no pleasure to make. In brief, sir, steady on the course of death.
Fair, Mr. Schreiner, hold this thought of us. And stay well. What company is this?
Master's for show to welcome us to town.
Gentlemen, every two in your party. Trying directly for two, you know. That is, that is still my only stutter. Before I have a husband for the other. And these are the people of that man, said the other one, and love you all. They usually have a good marriage pleasure.
The car for a rabbit. She's too got to be. They're their horses, you know. Will you have a wife?
I pray you, sir. Is it your wealth and his stallion or his mates?
Mates, mate. How do you mean that? No mates for you, unless you are of gentler and milder mold.
Thanks, sir, you shall never interfere. Ever since not halfway to our heart, but if it were, doubt not the strength of beings.
To call your noodle at the three-legged stool and paint your face and use you like a fool.
From all such devils, good Lord, deliver us.
And these noodle more.
Hush, master, here's some good pastime for you. That one tastes dark and bad, grows wonderful throat.
But in the other slabs, I see his mild behavior and sobriety. He is triumph.
Well said, master. Rose, it needs your fill.
Gentlemen, I must soon make your words say, young, get the aid. And let it not displease you, young, or I love you nearly less than you.
I'll knock you in the eye.
Sister, continuing discontent.
Sir, to your pleasure, I humbly subscribe. My books and instruments shall be my company. Unto them, to and happy to them.
Tanya, come get us here when you're in the speak.
Signor Baptista, will you be so strange? Sorry am I for our good will, thanks to Yama's grief.
Why will you lure her up, Signor Baptista? For this fiend of hell.
Love. bend all thoughts and ways to achieve her. Thus it stands. Her eldest sister is so cursed and shrewd that till her father rips his hands of her, Master, your love must live for aid at home. Therefore, he keeps her all closely mewed up, because she will not be annoyed with students.
Ah, what a cruel father is he! But art thou not advised? He did take some care to give a kind answer to his brother.
I marry am I, sir, and not just what?
I have it, Tranya.
Master, for my hand both are invented with meat and jumping water.
Tell me that first.
You shall be schoolmaster and undertake the teaching of the maid. That's your device.
It is. May it be done?
Not possible. For who shall learn your part and be in for doing here, Chentu's son? Keep house and find his book. Welcome his friends, visit his country, and make with them.
Foster, Contempius, frightful. We have not even seen in any house, nor can we lie distinguished by our faces with man or master. That follows us. Thou shalt be master. Tranya, in my stead, I will some other be. Tranya, at once. Take my colored hat and cloak. When Diadella comes, he waits on me, but I will try my first to keep his time.
So had you need. In brief, sir, sith it your pleasure is, I am content to be Lucentio, because so well I love Lucentio.
Because Lucentio loves, and let me be a slave to achieve that name whose sight and sight have frailed my wounded eye. Here comes the road. Sirrah, where have you been?
Where have I been? Nay, how have I? Where are you? Master, I've been both, Tranya, you have stolen your clothes. Or you've stolen his, or both. Pray, what is the news?
Sirrah, come hither. There's no time to jest. Therefore, bring your man to the time. Your fellow Tranya here can save my life. Put my apparel and my hands in time. For, in a quarrel since I came ashore, I killed a man and I was described. Wait you on him. I charge you, as becomes. Well, I made good intent to save my life. You understand me?
Aye, sir.
And not a jot of Tranio in your mouth. Tranio is changed into Chantio.
Better for him than the Irish of him.
Tranio, one more thing, master, that thyself execute to make one on these rules. That thou hast been lying, survive. My reasons are good and weak.
Comes there any more of it?
My good lord, tis just begun.
Tis a very excellent piece of work, madam lady. Good tour done.
as scattered young men through the world. Signor Hortensio, thus it stands with me. Antonio, my father, is deceased. I wrapped myself into this maze, happy to drive and thrive as best I may. Shall I then come round easily and wish me to a shrewd and ill-fared wife? Oh yes, I promise thee, she shall be very rich, and very rich indeed. But thou art too much, my friend, and I'll not wish thee to her.
Signor Hortensio, fix such friends as me, you were advised. I come to find a wealthy in Padua. If wealthy, then happy, Padua.
Why, nothing comes of this, so money comes from.
Petruchio, since we have stepped thus far in, I will continue that our oath suggests. I can treat you healthy to a wife, with wealth enough and young duties. God of his best becomes a gentleman. Her only fault, and that is fault enough, is that she is intolerable cursed, and shrewd and froward, so beyond all measure, that were my state far worse than it is, I would not wed her for a mine of gold.
Hortensio, peace. Thou knowest not both effect. Just tell me her father's name, and 'tis enough, for I will abhor her, though she tried as loud as thunder with the clouds of autumn breath.
Her father is Baptista Minola, an affable and courteous gentleman. Her name is Catherine Minola, renowned in Padua for her scolding tongue.
I know her father, though I know not her. And he knew my deceased father well. I will not leave Hortensio till I see her.
Tarry, Petruchio, I must go with thee. Her and Baptista's keep and treasure is. He hath the jewel of my life and hopes. His youngest daughter, beautiful Bianca. But now this order hath Baptista taken, that none shall have access unto Bianca until Catherine the cursed, and God a husband.
Hath Catherine the cursed, and title her maid with all the titles cursed.
Now shall my friend Petruchio do me grace, and offer me disguise and sober robes to old Baptista as a schoolmaster, well seen in music to instruct Bianca. Look, Grumio, tis the rival of my love. Petruchio, stand by a while.
A proper secret within enemies.
Hark to you, sir. I'll have them very fairly bound. I'll be so glad to see that in any man. See you read no other lectures to her. Take your paper, too, and see what happens very well in her view. For she disputed them with you himself. Do not go to only read to her.
Whate'er I read to her, I'll read for you, as firmly as yourself is still in place. Yea, and perhaps with more success for it than me, unless you are a scholar, sir.
Oh, this morning, what is the innocence?
Oh, this wooden heart, wooden master.
Please, sirrah! Grumio, mum, God save you, Signor Grumio.
You are not that, Signor Hortensio. Trow you whither I am going? To Baptista Minola. I promise to inquire carefully about schoolmaster of the fair Bianca. And by good fortune, I have fight well on this young man. For learning and behavior, fit for a student to read and poetry. And another course, good ones I've learned.
Tis well, now I met a gentleman that promised me to help me to another, a fine musician to instruct our mistress. Grumio, tis now the time to vent our lust. Listen to me, and if you speak me fair, I'll tell you news in different good variety. Here's a gentleman, whom by chance I met, will undertake to woo Catherine the Cursed, yea, and to marry her, for dowry please.
So, sir. So done, is well.
Hortensio, have you told her him about her faults?
I know she's an earth of raw skull. If that be all, masters, I'm here no harm.
But will you woo this wild cat?
Will I live?
Will you woo her?
I will woo her. Why come I hither but to that intent? Think you a little din can daunt my ears? Have I not, in my time, reviled your? Have I not heard, see puff with wind, rage like an angry boar take with sweat? Have I not, in the pigeon battle heard, loud alarms, neighs, geese, and trumpets clang? And now you tell me of a woman's tongue? Tush, tush, you mage is so bold. Tell me, I beseech you. Which is the readiest way to the house of the new Baptist of Nola?
He that hath two fair daughters is the
Even Evian, though.
Are you a suitor to the maid you speak of, yea or no?
And if I be, sir, is it any offense?
No! Go out more words, you will get me offense.
Why, sir, are not the streets as free from me as for you?
But so is not she.
For what reason, I beseech you?
For that reason, if you know that she is the choice love of Signor Tami.
That she is the chosen of Signor Hortensio.
Soft, my masters. If you be gentlemen, do me this right. Hear me with patience. Baptista is a noble gentleman, and were his daughter fairer than she is, she would more suitors have than me for one. And so she shall, the Tezio shall make one.
What? Will this gentleman out-talk us?
Sir, give him head, and I'll approve of yea.
Hortensio, what end are all these words?
Sir, let me be so bold as asking. Did you yet ever see Baptista's daughter?
No, sir. But here I do that he hath two. The one is famous for a scolding tongue. This is the other for beauteous modesty.
Sir, sir, the first one's for me. Let her go by.
I'll drink to that.
And I.
The motion's good indeed, and be it so. Petruchio, I shall be your friend who knew it.
Wrong me not, wrong yourself, to make a bondmaid and a slavery me, and bind my hands, I'll pull them off myself.
Of all thy suitors, here I charge to tell. Whom thou lovest best, see that is them not.
Believe me, sister, for all the men alive, I never yet beheld that special face which I could fancy more than any other.
Megan, thou liest! Isn't that Hortensio?
If you expect him, sister, here, I swear, I will plead for you myself, but you shall have him.
Oh, now be like, you fancy riches more. You let Gremio keep you there.
Is it for him to envy me so? Nay, then you just, now we will proceed. But have you just all this while? I prithee, sister, nay, untie my hand.
If that be just, then I'll press the stuff.
Bianca, stand aside. Poor girl, she weeps. I'll play the needle, metal down with her. Rest a long word at your own feet. Wait to cross with me.
For silence, thou queen. Now be revenge.
What, my sight? Bianca, get thee in.
What? You would suffer me? Nay, now I see. She is your treasure. She must have a husband. Talk not to me. I will go sit and weep till I can find occasion of revenge.
Is ever done when this dream is up?
Who goes to?
Good morrow, neighbor Baptista.
Good morrow, neighbor Gremio.
Thus sitting, gentlemen.
And you, good sir. Pray, have you not a daughter called Katharina, fair and virtuous?
I have a daughter, sir, named Katharina.
You are too blunt. Go to it orderly.
You wrong me, Signor Gremio. Give me leave. I am a gentleman of Roma, sir. That, hearing of her beauty and her wit, her affability and bashful modesty, her wondrous quality and mild behavior, and bold to show myself before a guest within your house, to make mine eye witness of that report which I have got from her.
hear me strum a simple instrument. And this small packet of Greek and Latin books. If you accept them, then the work is great.
The change is you. Of what, sir?
Of Pisa, sir. Subtin Vincentio.
A mighty man of Pisa. Army for a known world. Now you take the loot and you stab the books. You should go see.
Myself, I am moved to woo thee for my wife.
Moved? And good.
bed.
Was there a mask clapped up so suddenly?
Big gentleman, can I play the merchant's part and venture on this desperate march?
But now, back to your younger daughter. Today is the day we long have hope for. I am your neighbor, and was tutor first.
And I am going to love Bianca more than worthy witness, or your thoughts can guess.
Youngling, thou canst fall, so use I.
Greybeard, thy love doth grace. Continue, gentlemen, I'm resolved. Tis the deeds most willing prize. When you both have been sure my daughter, greatest dower, shall have my daughter's love. Citizen of Grimio, what can you ensure?
First, as you know, my house within the city, which is richly furnished with plate and gold, and ivory coffers I have stuffed my crowns, turkey cushions boxed with pearls, pewter and brass, and other household things that befit the house. Myself am stuck in ears, I must confess. But if I die tomorrow, she shall be only mine.
That always came well in. Sir, listen to me. I am my father's heir, only son. If I may have your daughter to my wife, I'll leave her houses free, or four is good, within rich people walls, as anyone old in Romania has a widow of, besides 2,000 ducats by the year of fruitful land, all of which shall be her joint heir. What of my pastries, Signor Gamio?
2,000 ducats by the year of land? My land amounts not to that much at all. But besides an argosy that now is lying in the middle of the road, what, have I choked you with an argosy?
Gamio, 'tis known my father has no less than 3 great argosies, and these I will assure, and twice as much whate'er the offer.
Nay, I have offered all of this. I have no more. And she can have no more than all I have. If you like me, sir, pray, accept me.
Why then, the fate is mine from all the world. By your firm promise, Gremio is out of mind. I have to confess, your offer is the best. Let your father make the assurance. She is your own. Thus shall live, and resolve. On Sunday next, you know, Catherine and Petruchio are to be married, and Sunday following shall be openly yours. If you this assurance, if not, Signor Gremio, so I take my leave and thank you both.
I do, good neighbor. Youngling, thy father were a fool to give thee all his money in 20 age.
A vengeance on my craft with a tie. 'Tis in my head to do my master good. I see no reason but suppose Lucentio shall get a father called suppose Vincentio. And that's a wonder. Fathers commonly do this with children. But in this case of wooing, the child should get aside if I fail that of my kind.
Sim, I am defenseless. Pick S, some of the sensitive. tell us the sky is once the picture above. Make this air, and that will turn to the common wood. Mania is my name. With Revia, there my fort, Jelsa says, and then I figure out the old path.
And then, tis now in tune, left here. Oh, fire, this double jar.
All of them. Spin the whole man, tune again.
Now, let me see you guys in the history. Pick it back, in moment. And know you not. Pick F, if you tell it. I trust you not. Pick sure F, free me. Pick you, he hears not. Pick you, pick you not. Delta, seven. This is right now.
The name is now in two.
All of the base.
The base is right. Base made the drops. How fiery and forward our pendant is. Now, for my life, name the fort my love.
In time I may believe, yet in myself.
Mistrust it not.
I must play my master, else I promise you, I should still be arguing upon the death, but let it rest.
You may go on, and give me the war. My lessons make no music in three parts.
Are you so formal, sir? Well, I must wait and watch it all, for I would be a seed, our fine magician brother genius.
Madame, before you touch the instrument, to learn the order of my finger, I must begin with rudiments of art to teach you gamut and a brief sword, and have ever been taught any of my trade. And there it is in writing, barely dropped.
Why, I'm having my gamut on the wood.
And read the gamut and seal.
And I am the ground of all accord. A reed to plead for tend of passion. Be me, the ombre, taken for thy lord. Deep love, that loves all affection. Deep story, one plus two notes have I. You on me, show pity or I die. How is gamut, and like it not, old fashioned please be best, be not to me. To change the world for old dimensions. Very well, I must be gone.
Think, mistress, when I have no cause to stay.
But I have cause to cry into this pennant. He thinks he looks as if he were in love.
Why, that's
therefore hath thou these words. To me she is married, not unto my clothes.
We have some eating in his bad attire. We will persuade him, be it possible, to put on better gear to go to church.
All out of room and see the happy locusts.
Holla, master. I need to get a man, whate'er he be, and he shall be Vincenzo of Pisa, and give a shirt here in Padua a greater sum than I promised.
Were it not that my fellow schoolmaster has lodged behind the steps so narrowly, he thinks it good to be our marriage, which, once performed, let the whole world fain know. But I'll keep mine up, despite of all the world.
We'll overreach the great Romeo, the narrow pride of father, Fidola, the great musician, the arbors and leech, all for my master's sake, Vicentio. Signor Romeo, came you from the church?
As lovely as ere I came from school.
Then who is the bridegroom coming home?
A bridegroom, say you? Tis a groom indeed, a grumbling groom, and that girl shall find.
Person is she, why tis impossible.
Why? He's a devil, a very fiend.
Why, she's the devil, the devil's damned.
What? She's a lamb, a dog, a fool to him. Then the priest should ask if Catherine should be his wife. I, by all that's holy, quoth he, and swore so loud that the all-amazed priest let fall the book. And as he bent to pick it up again, the mad brain grabbed him from such a cup. The down fell priest and book, and book and priest.
What next?
After many ceremonies done, he calls for wine. A health, quoth he, as if he had been abroad, cruising with his mates after a storm. Quaffed off the muscadel and threw the socks in the sexton's face. After that done, he took the bride about the neck and kissed her with such a clatter smack. And at the parting, all the church did echo. Such a mad marriage never was before.
Gentlemen and friends, I thank you for your pains. I know you think to dine with me today, and have your great store of voyage here. But so it is, my face can call me hence, and therefore fear on me to take my leave.
Is it possible you're away tonight?
I must away today, before night comes. And, honest company, I thank you all. Dine with my father, drink a health to me, but deliver this eye, and here I leave you.
Let us entreat you to stay till after dinner.
It may not be.
Let me entreat you.
It cannot be.
Let me entreat you.
I'm content.
I intend to stay.
I'm content you shall entreat me to stay. But yet, not stay. Entreat me how you can.
Now for love, stay.
Romeo, my horse.
I serve they regret the old time of the horses.
Nay then, do what thou canst. I will not go today, nor tomorrow, nor shall I myself. The door is open, sir, and there lies your way.
Okay, content thee. matter, though. We've never made it.
I warned him. But Rubio is hated.
My master and mistress fall out.
How?
Out of their
about sheep. This week is still sheep. True, my master is shepherd. The shepherd sees the sheep, and not the sheep the shepherd. But I seek my master, and my master seeks not me. Therefore, I am the sheep. The sheep the Father follows the shepherd. The shepherd for food follows not the sheep. I, the wages, follows my master. My master, the wages, follows not me. Therefore, I am the sheep. Such a little makes me cry, bah! Away, away, for he is coming hither!
Thus, I have politically begun my reign. It is my hope, as successfully. She ate no meat today, nor none shall eat. Last night she sat down, nor tonight she shall not. As for the meat, some undeserving fault all find about the making of the bed. Here always the pillow, there the bolster, this way the coverlet, another way the sheets. Aye, and amid this curly, I intend that all is done in reverent care of her. That, to conclude, she shall wash all night, and if she chances not, I'll rail and brawl, and with the clamor keep her still awake. This is the way to kill your wife with kindness, and thus I'll curb her mad headstrong humor. He that knows better how to tame a shrew, now let him speak. 'Tis charity to show.
God save you, sir.
And you, sir, shall be far on, or I will try.
love any light.
What countryman, I pray?
A Mantua.
A Mantua, sir! God forbid! And come you to Mantua, careless of your life?
My life, sir. How, I pray? That goes hard.
Tis death for anyone in Mantua to come to you. Know you not the cause?
Alas, sir, it is worse than so. Proud bills of money by exchange. From thorns, unless you deliver them.
Well, sir, to do you courtesy, this will I do, and this I will advise you. First, tell me, sir, have you ever met a king?
Aye, sir, and he that I often met. He's our down for brave citizens.
Among them, know you one, Vincentio?
I know him not, but I've often heard of him. A merchant of incomparable wealth.
He is my father, sir, and sooth to say, in countenance, somewhat doth resemble you.
As much as an average of the voice all one.
To save your life in this extremity, this favor will I do you for his sake. His name and credit you shall undertake, and in my house be brother lodged, if this courtesy, sir, accept of it.
Oh, sir, I do honor with you ever the patron for my life and liberty.
Then go with me to make the matter good. This, by the way, I let you understand. My father is here to look for every day to pass assurance that a dower of marriage tricks me and one of Baptista's daughter. In all these circumstances, I will instruct you. Now go with me to close the
I'll pay your company.
You don't want luck, Vincenzo.
meal and bread, but it is not just that cup.
God's grace many things
I have.
To you I say, feast on me. I bid you cut off the gown, not cut it in pieces.
Why, dear, the old fashioned sister,
free it.
And put it in loose body gown.
I never said a loose body gown, I said a gown.
With a small capacity.
I confess to you.
With the trunk sleeves.
I confess to you.
Is
there's ability.
Aaron the bill, sir. Aaron the bill.
This is true that I say, and I have had the pleasure of not sure to know.
Well, sir, in brief, the gown was not for me.
You are in the right, sir. It is for my mistress.
Kensio, say thou wilt see the tailor pay. Go, take it hence. Be gone and say no more.
Taylor, I'll pay thee for the gown tomorrow. Away, I say, and then we to thy master.
Look how my faith, you return unto thy father's house, even in these honest meek filaments. Our furniture shall be proud, our garments poor, for 'tis fun that makes thy rich. Let's see. I think 'tis now 7 o'clock, and we will make it there by dinner time.
I dare assure you, sir, 'tis almost 2. It will be supper time, very pleasant.
It shall be 7 ere I go to court. Look. I speak, or do, or think to do, you are so roughing it. Sir, let alone, I will not go today, and ere I do, it shall be 1 o'clock, I say it is.
Why, so this gown will command the sun.
Sunshine.
virgin, fair, fresh, and sweet.
Whither away, or where is thy abode?
Happy are the parents of so fair a child.
Why? How now, King? I hope thou art not mad. This is a man, old, wrinkled, faded, withered, and not of maiden, as thou sayest he is.
Pardon, old father, for my mistaken eyes. I've been so bedazzled by the sun that everything I look on is like green.
Now I perceive thou art a reverend father. Pardon, old father, for my mistaken.
You, good old grandsire, in the Gothic known to us between our tablets. Come on with us. You shall be joyful of my company.
Fair sir, my very best dress. That was a strange encounter and much to make. My name is called Vincentia. My dwelling is Pisa, and down there to Padua, there to visit a son of mine whose long I have not seen.
What's his name?
Lucentio, gentle sir.
Happy we meet, and happier for thy son. And now, my law, as well as reverend age, I may entitle thee my loving father, thy sister to my wife, this gentleman, thy son by this of marriage. Wonder not, joy be free, she is of good esteem, for dowry wealthy and of worthy birth.
But is it true, or else is it your pleasure, like country travelers, to bring jests upon the company you overtake?
I do assure thee, father, so it is. Come, go along, and see the truth about. I see thy first merriment hath made thee jealous.
My servant.
Well, I'm sure. Nay, what?
can be hailed and abused. Oh, monster villain.
Oh, fierce foot, and yonder he is. Deny it, I swear, or else we are all in jeopardy.
Pardon, sweet father.
Where's my sweet son?
Pardon, dear father.
Press the vision. Where is the sitio?
Here is Vicentio, right son to the right Vincentio. And have by marriage, named thy daughter mine. And counterfeits of false is believed by mine.
Where's that son to Antonio that faced the brave queen in this matter so?
Why, is that this way, Cambio?
Cambio changed into Vicentio. Love wrought these miracles. Bianca's love made me exchange my state with Tranio. Well, he did bear my conscience in the town. Happily, I am arrived into the last, unto the wish even of my bliss. What Tranio did, myself enforced him to. Then pardon her, sweet father, for my sake.
I'll slip the villain's nose. That would have sent me to the jail.
But do you hear, sir? Have you made my daughter not my good will?
Fear not, Baptista, we'll content you. Go to, but I will enter your revenge for this villainy.
It hard to sell the depths of this knavery.
Look not here, Bianca, my father will not frown.
My cake is full, but all among the rest. Out of my share, to get my share of the feast.
Husband, let's follow us to the end of this journey.
First, kiss me, cake, and we will.
What, am I missing the street?
What, art thou ashamed of me?
No, sir, God forbid, but ashamed to kiss.
Why, then let's home again. Come strong, let's away.
Nay, I will give thee a kiss. No, really, love, stay.
Will it be so? Come, my sweet cake. Better once than never, for never too late.
Her down. That's my
their strengths. Here is a wonder, and top of wonder.
And so it is. I wonder what it boasts.
Fair. Peace it boasts, and love, and quiet life. And, to be sure, what's not that sweet and happy?
The fearful quality good for Shrew, the way she got us for us. Nimble has been 20,000 crowns. Another daughter with another daughter. She has changed, she has never been before.
Nay, I will win my wager better yet, and show more signs of her obedience. See when he comes and brings your forward lives as prisoners of a womanly persuasion. Katharina, that calf becomes you not. Off it, throw it under the foot.
Bye, what a foolish duty to call you this.
I'm going your duty of course too. For the worst you have your duty, my fair Bianca, half cost me 100 crowns since supper time.
The more fool you for lying on my duty.
Come, Katharina, and tell these